Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the IFAC Handa Australian Singing Competition Finals Concert. My name is Camille Merchep, and it is my privilege to be your host for this evening of wonderful music making. Before we begin, I wish to acknowledge the traditional custodians of the land on which we stand, the Cammeraygal people of the Eora Nation, their spirits and their ancestors. As we appreciate our own young talents within this hall, may we also pay respect to the knowledge and artistry embedded forever within the Aboriginal custodianship of country. And before we go any further, can I now please ask you to turn off your mobile phones? Thank you. And now I would like to welcome some honoured guests in our audience tonight, their excellencies, the Governor-General of the Commonwealth of Australia, General the Honourable David Hurley, AC-DSC, and Mrs. Linda Hurley. Thank you for affirming the continuing importance of the arts for the Australasian community. Tonight, our finalists will be accompanied by the Opera Australia Orchestra. The OAO is the country's busiest orchestra, giving about 300 performances a year, performing a broad range of repertoire of concert works, ballets, and of course, opera. As the resident orchestra at the Sydney Opera House, they work alongside many of the world's most distinguished artists, and we're honoured to have their experience assisting our finalists to give their best performances this evening. For over two decades, finalists in this competition have enjoyed the remarkable opportunity of performing with an orchestra. And this is thanks to the generous support of Dr. Haruhisa Handa and the International Foundation for Arts and Culture. Dr. Handa is a well-known supporter of a range of important events around Australia, including Handa Opera on the Harbour, which has become an unmissable annual event. Unfortunately, Dr. Handa is unable to be here tonight, but we are very pleased to welcome his Director of International Affairs, Ms. Midori Miyazaki, and patron of IFAC, former Prime Minister of Australia, the Honourable Tony Abbott. This year, we had entrants from around Australia and New Zealand, as well as some singers overseas, who were given the opportunity to be heard digitally. From those many entrants, 10 talented young singers progressed through to our semi-finals, which is not just one exciting concert, but a week of activities designed to both test and strengthen our competitors. The first of those activities is the workshop, and this year it was presented at the Opera House by Opera Australia. Led by Joanne Goodman, Senior Artist Manager, the workshop gave the singers the opportunity to listen to guidance from specialist language coach Nicole Dorigo and director Sean Rennie. And the semi-finalists were then given a fascinating behind-the-scenes tour by stage manager Gary Alcorn. And finally, global superstar and 2003 Marty winner Jessica Pratt sat with the semi-finalists for an insightful and open Q&A. Thank you, Opera Australia, for arranging this incredible afternoon. And next came the thrill of seeing all 10 singers perform over the various stages of the semi-finals, culminating in the public concert which was held at the Independent Theatre in July. This year, the talent has been extraordinary, making the semi-finals one of the most competitive we've seen in recent years. All the singers were accompanied by celebrated accompanist and repetiteur Bradley Gilchrist. And I encourage you to catch up with all those performances on our YouTube channel. It's a fascinating look into the singers' development, and we're quietly proud that this YouTube channel has had to date nearly 2 million views. A hallmark of the Australian singing competition is the calibre of our adjudicators. From the teams of professionals that oversee the heats around the country and overseas, to the panels which adjudicate the semi-finals and finals. These adjudicators generously give their time and expertise as they carefully assess the needs and talents of the contestants. It is with pleasure that I will now introduce you to tonight's adjudication panel. This year's national adjudicator is Patrick Tor. Patrick is an Australian classical music artist manager and former principal tenor with Opera Australia. He also spent many years in the Phantom of the Opera, in which he performed the role of Piangi over 1,000 times. As many of you may be aware, Patrick faced the sudden loss of his beloved wife, Romola Tyrrell, earlier this year. Romola was a popular soprano who went on to be a respected artist manager and co-director of Patrick Tor Artist Management. She was also once a finalist in the Australian Singing Competition, where she was awarded the coveted Royal Overseas League Scholarship. To mark her passing, Music and Opera Singers Trust would like to dedicate tonight's finals concert to her memory. We are extremely grateful to Patrick for accepting our invitation to be the National Adjudicator for 2023 and for his dedication to the role under such difficult circumstances. Joining Patrick on the panel this evening are specialist language coach Nicole Dorigo, renowned Australian soprano and Marti winner Amelia Farrugia. Representing Opera Australia is Australian conductor and the chorus master of Opera Australia, Paul Fitzsimon. And finally, representing the Sydney Conservatorium of Music, we have soprano Dr. Anke Höeppner-Ryan, who is a lecturer in vocal studies. Please give them a round of applause. Thank you. And conducting tonight's performance is Maestro Vladimir Fanshil, an established conductor, pianist, and concert curator renowned for his work covering symphonic, operatic, and ballet genres. He's worked with many international orchestras, including the Budapest Festival Orchestra, Konzerthaus Orchestra Berlin, Luxembourg Philharmonic, and Mariinsky Orchestra, just to name a few. And during the coronavirus pandemic, Vladimir founded the musical company Live at Yours, bringing salon-style concerts to new audiences. Please welcome Maestro Vladimir Fanshil. Our first performer tonight is 22-year-old mezzo-soprano Cassandra Doyle from Sydney. Cassandra will be performing Amour vient rendre à mon âme from Gluck's opera Orphée et Eurydice. This aria is sung in Act Two of the opera by the character Orpheus, a legendary musician and poet. Orpheus pleads with the god of love to restore his Eurydice to life. Eurydice has died, and Orpheus is determined to rescue her from the underworld. Please welcome Cassandra Doyle to sing Gluck's Amour vient rendre à mon âme.
Oh!
Cassandra, for that wonderful performance. And now, our second performer from Sydney is 25-year-old soprano Yvette Keong. Yvette will sing Se il padre perdei from Mozart's opera Idomeneo. Se il padre perdei, or If I Have Lost My Father, is sung by the character Ilia in Act One of the opera. Ilia is the daughter of King Priam of Troy. And in this aria, she expresses her sadness and longing after being captured and taken as a prisoner of war by the Greeks. Please welcome Yvette Keong to sing Mozart's Se il padre perdei. Thank you, Yvette, for that moving performance. 23-year-old mezzo-soprano Ellena Hicks is originally from Orange, and she will be singing Handel's Svegliatevi nel cuore from Giulio Cesare in Egitto. Translated as Awaken in My Heart, the aria is a piece sung by Sesto, son of Cornelia and Pompey. In the aria, Sesto reassures his mother that he will avenge the death of his father, who was assassinated by the Egyptians, to show their loyalty to Julius Caesar. Please welcome Ellena Hicks.
Thank you.
you, Ellena, for that powerful performance. Our next performer is Emmanuel Fonoti-Fuimaono. Emmanuel is a 25-year-old tenor from New Zealand, and tonight Emmanuel has chosen to perform from Mozart's Magic Flute, Dies Bildnis ist bezaubernd schön. This beautiful aria is about love at first sight and is sung by Tamino, a prince, who is embarked on a quest to rescue the princess Pamina from the clutches of the evil sorcerer Sarastro. Here, Prince Tamino has been presented with an image of Pamina. He falls instantly in love, which naturally deepens his desire to rescue her. Please welcome Emmanuel Fonoti-Fuimaono to sing Dies Bildnis ist bezaubernd schön.
Bezaubernd schön, wie noch kein Auge je gesehen. Ich fühl es, wie es Götterbild mein Herz mit nicht war nicht nennen, doch fühl ich sie wie Feuer brennen. Soll die Empfindung Liebe sein, soll die Empfindung Liebe sein.
Thank you, Emmanuel, for that lovely performance. Our next performer, Michaela Cadwgan, is a 25-year-old soprano, also from New Zealand. Tonight she'll be performing Voi lo sapete, o mamma, from Mascagni's Cavalleria Rusticana. Alone with Mamma Lucia, Santuzza tells her tragic story. Santuzza is in love with Mamma Lucia's son, Turidu, who is now involved with a married woman, Lola. In this aria, Santuzza reveals the pain and shame she feels due to her relationship with Turidu. Taking us to a small village in Sicily is Michaela Cadwgan with Voi lo sapete o mamma.
Thank you.
Thank you, Michaela. Well, we have now heard all five finalists sing their first items, and what an incredible demonstration of the richness of talent that our region has to offer. While we catch our breaths after all that emotion, it seems an opportune time to tell you a little bit about the history of the competition. The Australian Singing Competition was established by solicitor Roland Gridiger to realise the vision of his client, dedicated singing teacher Marianne Marty Frisdane. Over the years, many luminaries of the music fraternity have given their expert advice on how to structure the competition and have also helped with the development and acquisition of valuable scholarships. The competition has been operating for over 40 years and is administered by Music and Opera Singers Trust Limited. Over 3,000 singers have participated in the competition and have had the benefit of being heard and interviewed by eminent professionals from the classical singing fraternity. Of the winners of the primary prizes, the majority are pursuing careers in Australia and overseas, and as are many of the other singers who have shared well over $3 million worth of prizes or valuable opportunities. None of this would be possible without the support of our amazing sponsors and prize givers, many of whom are in the audience tonight. There are far too many to name individually, but if you visit the website, you can view all our sponsors' details. Thank you to all of you for your belief in the importance of the competition. But now, let's get back to the music. First up is soprano Yvette Keong, who will sing Parleront, Salut à la France, from Donizetti's La Fille du Régiment. Marie is bemoaning her fate. Alone and away from her family, she feels that money and status are meaningless. Suddenly, she hears soldiers marching in the distance, and she is delighted by the return of the regiment and her beloved Tornio. She leads them in singing a patriotic tribute. Here to tell the story, Yvette Keong.
Oh,
Thank you, Yvette. Mezzo-soprano Ellena Hicks will take us now on a journey of the Greek poet Sappho with Gounod's Omalia Immortel. The song follows the story of Sappho's great love for Phaon, who by the end curses her for her refusal to leave Lesbos with him. In spite of that, she forgives him, but mourns her loss in the aria before she commits suicide. Please welcome Ellena Hicks with Gounod's Omalia Immortel.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ellena. Emmanuel Fonoti-Fuimaono returns now to sing Ah, Lève-toi Soleil from Gounod's Roméo et Juliette. After exchanging a few words with Juliette at the Capulets' party, Roméo wishes to see her again and makes his way to the garden of the Capulets. Outside her window, he sees a light turn on in Juliette's room, and Roméo imagines the light as a sunrise, describing Juliette as the sun of his life. Please welcome Emmanuel Fonoti-Fuimaono to sing Ah, Lève-toi Soleil.
Para, ostra, pure,
Thank you, Emmanuel. Now another aria from Gounod's Roméo et Juliette. Que fais-tu, blanche tourterelle? Will be sung by Cassandra Doyle. Stefano's aria, while not true to Shakespeare's original Romeo and Juliet, provides a moment of comic relief before the heavy turning point of drama. Stefano baits the Capulets with his mocking song, which states that the white dove of the Capulets will go free one day to join the Montagues in love. Please welcome to the stage Cassandra Doyle to sing Que fais-tu, blanche tourterelle?
Tortorella, vos e sol.
Thank you, Cassandra. We now come to our final contestant for this evening, Michaela Cadwgan, who will sing Die teure Halle from Wagner's Tannhäuser. Like many of his operas, Wagner's Tannhäuser is based on German legends and the struggle of love. In this Act II aria, Die teure Halle, Elizabeth hears that her love, Tannhäuser, is coming back to the Hall of Song, which is the site of many of his triumphs in singing competitions. Elizabeth greets the hall with great joy as it awakens once more. To perform Die teure Halle, please welcome back Michaela Cadwgan.
Thank you.
Thank you, Michaela, for what a magnificent finish to the competitive segment of tonight's concert. And now it's time for our adjudicators to depart to begin their difficult deliberations. Please join me in offering a round of applause as they leave our hall. Our national adjudicator Patrick Tor and panel Nicole, Dorigo, Amelia, Farrugia, Paul Fitzsimon, and Anke, Höeppner-Ryan. Thank you. And a big thank you too to Maestro Vladimir Fanshil and the Opera Australia Orchestra led by Catherine Lukey. And finally, a reminder that as members of the audience, you too have an important job to do at interval by voting for your favourite singer for the $500 Most Audience Prize. By doing so, you'll be eligible to be in the draw for a fabulous Nespresso machine. So this year, the voting will once again be happening online, and if you look in your program, there is a QR code. Scan this link into your phones and it'll take you to a website through which you can vote. And could I please ask you to vote early in the interval so that we can make sure we have a winner in time for the prize giving. Now, please enjoy some refreshments which can be purchased in the foyer, and I look forward to seeing you back here in 20 minutes. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Roland Rittiger. I'm delighted just to talk to you briefly to let you know that we started quite a number of years ago, 1983, was humble with piano. And then Dr. Handa came, and through his vision and foresight, we were able to engage an orchestra, a wonderful orchestra. And we would like to honour Dr. Handa and to thank Midori Miyazaki, his Director of International Affairs, and the IFAC patron, the Honourable Tony Abbott, who you've heard about, and the Chairman, David Mortimer AO. We'd like to sort of thank them. We'd like to show you some snippets, vignettes, as my professor would tell me. We would like to show you some snippets of how the orchestra has helped, has assisted the young singers from piano to the performances that you see at the finals of the Australian Singing Competition. Hopefully.
Next, I'm delighted to introduce the national sponsor of the Australian Singing Competition, Dr. Haruhisa Handa, businessman, philanthropist, enthusiastic patron of the arts, as well as practitioner of many art forms, including music.
Well, welcome back to the second half of this very exciting evening. Now, if you'll please welcome to the stage again, Maestro Vladimir Fanshil. And while the adjudicators are still deciding on their winners, we have a delightful guest artist to keep us entertained. Our guest artist tonight is 2023 Opera Award winner Ellena Greenwood. A versatile soprano, Ellena has sung in London, Europe, Australia, and throughout China. A graduate of London's Royal Academy of Music Opera School and of the Australian National University, she has performed various roles and in numerous concerts. Tonight she will sing Io son d'umile ancella from Celea's Adriana Le Couvreur. Please welcome Ellena Greenwood to the stage.
Oh!
Thank you, Eleanor Greenwood. And please thank Maestro Vladimir Fanshil and the Opera Australia Orchestra, not only for that splendid performance, but also for the wonderful support they've given to our five finalists, both in their preparation during today's rehearsals and in their performances this evening. Tonight, we're honoured that His Excellency General the Honourable David Hurley, ACDSC, has agreed to make some comments from the stage. Throughout his tenure, His Excellency has shown an unwavering commitment to celebrating the creative spirit that defines us as Australians. From the traditional to the contemporary, from the Indigenous to the multicultural, Governor General Hurley's inclusive approach reflects his deep understanding that the arts have the power to weave together stories, emotions, and perspectives that bind us as one people. Please welcome His Excellency General, the Honourable David Hurley, ACDSC.
Well, good evening, and absolute delight for Linda and I to be back again this year for such a special competition in the life of the arts in Australia. And could I just acknowledge all our distinguished guests who are here tonight and just thank you for being here and showing your support. In 1982, Sir Zelman Cowan, when he launched the Marian Marta Scholarship, said that this would be a great encouragement to the arts in Australia. Well, he'll spot on, because here we are 40 years later and have encouraged a generation of great young artists to follow their dreams, to commit themselves to what I think is the highest art form there is, that reaches our hearts, our minds, all those sentiments that opera just expresses so well. So tonight, in this, I think, tradition of giving back, as Marian did with being a singer herself, a teacher, a mentor, we've had another opportunity to support, with your magnificent support in the orchestra tonight, our next generation of singers. Now, only one will win tonight. That's unfortunate, but we should congratulate Cassandra, Yvette, Ellena, Emmanuel, and Michaela for such beautiful singing. We've been entranced, and we know that each of them has so much more to offer into the future, and tonight is just a stepping stone. So we look forward to hearing about them in their careers in the future. My main job tonight, though, is to congratulate most, Handa, you, all those involved in bringing this competition together, to allow us to experience the joy of opera, but to add our encouragement to these fine young people who perform for us tonight. Thank you for being here tonight. Thank you for your ongoing support. I say it in a sense as well that Linda and I have been very blessed over the last 6 weeks or so. We've attended the Sydney International Piano Competition, patron of that. We've been up to Townsville with the Australian Festival of Chamber Music. We launched the Canberra Symphony Orchestra season last week. I come from Canberra, I have hay fever, so excuse me. And tonight we have the opera, a singing competition. I say that because it just shows how rich our country is and how dedicated people are to pursuing the arts and bringing them into the lives of Australians. So again, all involved in the Handa Australia Singing Competition, thank you for allowing these five young men and women to express themselves to us, to follow their passions, and whoever wins tonight is on one path, but they're all on their own direction. So thank you again. Look forward to next year's competition. We're working on Handa. We're not joking when we say this, but the Opera House will be really nice. This is lovely, but we'd like to fill the Opera House for a singing competition in Australia. So if you've got another vote on your machine there tonight, do that. and that'll be lovely to be able to do. $3.6 million of prizes have come out of this competition to put young people into great locations to learn, to come back and to excite us. And just, if you're not an opera lover, you wouldn't be here tonight. Where's Alfredo? Is he here tonight? Alfredo, where are you? Can I see you? I can't see you in the light. Ah, there he is. He runs the best Italian restaurant in town. It's a Pycrobe. I was there for my birthday last Saturday night. He looked after us royally, but more than that, he loves opera, supports opera, and creates opportunity, and that's what this competition's about. So keep it going. Thank you.
Thank you, Your Excellency, for those insightful words. Through the International Foundation for Arts and Culture, Dr. Haruhisa Handa contributes to many important causes around the world and has given financial assistance to this competition for an incredible 25 years. Dr. Handa has requested that the Honourable Tony Abbott, AC, former Prime Minister of Australia and IFAC patron, speak tonight on his behalf. Please join me in welcoming the Honourable Tony Abbott to the microphone.
You have to be optimistic about Australia, indeed optimistic about Australasia, when you have such wonderfully talented young people to lead our country forward, and in particular, to preserve and extend the high culture which has been such a wonderful gift to the world. So my first task this evening is to thank our five finalists for the extraordinary treat of soaring sound they've given us, and to congratulate them on giving the judges such an incredibly challenging task. My second task is to acknowledge the wonderful work of Dr. Haruhisa Handa, who has helped to make this splendid competition possible. I have to tell you that Dr. Handa is one of the most selfless people I have ever met, a highly successful businessman, a talented amateur actor and singer himself, who doesn't just give away some of his wealth, he gives away all of it to so many good causes all around the world, but including in this country, trying to help fine people to be their best selves at some of the best things anyone can do. And haven't we seen a wonderful example of fine young people being absolutely their best selves this evening? I think that the world is so much the better for the presence in it of people like Dr. Handa. We wish there were more like him. But tonight, we are grateful to him for what he has done for this competition and for our country, not for 25 years, but indeed for 28 years in the case of this particular competition. And our country is so much the better for it. Let's give him the round of applause that he deserves.
Thank you, Mr. Abbott. As many of you know, MOST is dedicated to propelling young performers into their musical careers, as well as recognising great achievements in the arts. In keeping with this mission, in 2016, MOST established a new accolade, the MOST Achievement Award, or the MARS, as we like to call them. The MARS are awarded to a talented individual who has demonstrated a passion to contribute to the industry, and it is offered to someone who supports their artistic community and contributes to its development, as well as to the cultural life of Australia as a whole. Recipients are nominated and selected by a panel of industry peers convened by MOST. I would now like to invite to the stage Roland Gridiger, CEO of Music and Opera Singers Trust, to announce this year's winner of the MOST Achievement Award.
Look, I'm supposed to read this speech, but before I do, I've just got to say how grateful we are that we could have their excellencies here this evening with us. It's quite extraordinary when you think about it, that we start a little competition and then it sort of grows and we get an orchestra and we have the Honourable Tony Abbott here, we have His Excellency and Her Excellency here. I just want to say thank you. It's not part of my speech, but thank you to the orchestra too. I hope you like seeing yourself on the big screen because you all look terrific. But anyway, I'm here now to talk about the MAR. So the recipient of this year's MAR has most recently been appointed as Artistic Director to the Victorian Opera. He began his operatic career as a stage manager in 1978 with the Australian Opera and subsequently became Staff Director for the company in 1981. His association with the National Opera Company has been a constant throughout his professional career. He was appointed by Simone Young to the position of Artistic Administrator in 1999 and then was Executive Director from 2004 to 2008. He has since been General Director of New Zealand Opera as well as Artistic Director of Opera South Australia. He lived and worked in the UK for a number of years, where he worked as staff director at Covent Garden and directed a number of productions in the UK. Most recently, this year, he was appointed patron of Opera Brava in London. His directorial flair in a myriad of styles and genres has marked him as one of the foremost directors in Australia of his generation. As well as directing opera, he has directed with great distinction and wit the works of Gilbert and Sullivan, as well as the works of Stephen Sondheim. His passion for singing and singers is well known by his colleagues who have had privilege of working with him on productions over decades. He has offered his services selflessly to many of the conservatoires and opera departments in Australasia, so that the next generation of opera stars might benefit from his vast source of knowledge and experience. His curiosity and scholarship is unearthing hitherto forgotten gems, for the performance has been a great boon to the art form in this country. His commitment to the nurturing and development of careers at their genesis was recognised in 2012 with his being awarded a Member of the Order of Australia, an MA, in which the citation stated, for the service of the performing arts and the mentoring of young emerging artists. It gives me great pleasure, ladies and gentlemen, to announce that this year's recipient of the MAR is Stuart Maunder. Now, unfortunately, Stuart is unable to be with us tonight as he is hard at work at the dress rehearsal for Macbeth. So to accept the award on his behalf is soprano, actress, pianist, conductor, director, and music teacher, Anne-Marie MacDonald. And Stuart has also kindly sent the following brief video message accepting his MOST awards. So hopefully we'll see the video.
Hello, greetings from sunny Adelaide. Oh, well, I have to say I'm overwhelmed, to say the least. And this comes from a boy who's never won a raffle. So to say that I'm chuffed is an understatement. I am very, very honoured to be receiving the Most Achievement Award, not only because the past recipients of this award are an august group and I look forward to joining their ranks as a junior member, but also because this comes from a foundation whose sole aim is to help young singers forge careers. I started directing the year before the Amati Award was first presented, and I look back over the lists of finalists and winners, and I have to say that in my 40 years of directing, I don't think there's ever been a show where I haven't directed at least one finalist or winner of the Marty Award. Today I'm in Adelaide directing Paul O'Neill as Macduff in Verdi's Macbeth. Earlier in the year I directed Jake Bigwood in Carmen for West Australian Opera. Jeremy Kleeman was here in the Gilbert and Sullivan Festival. It goes on and on. And I'm pleased to announce, but I'm not going to tell you the full story, I'm pleased to announce that in my first year at Victorian Opera, we'll be showcasing Keandra Howarth and Kang Wang in a little-known Puccini opera, but that's another story. Now, all of these singers have studied and have consequently forged careers overseas. And there are many people, of course, who bemoan the fact that Australians have to go overseas in order to start their careers. But I'm afraid 'twas ever thus. We just simply have a too small a population base to be able to allow many people to come here and have a full-time career in opera. It's a very different time from when I joined Opera Australia, or the Australian Opera as it was called then, in 1978. Then we had 36 singers that were on full-time salary with Opera Australia. And at any night of the week, you could have put on a Bohème or a Traviata or a Figaro and probably cast it three times over. I was also lucky enough to be able to forge a career in opera here. Those days have gone, and for many reasons, mainly economic, I suppose, but there are still many opportunities here for some singers, but most will have to go overseas. And that's, of course, where most comes into operation. Allowing kids the chance to go over to hone their craft, to strut their stuff, to start their careers. That's the first part of the equation. The second part of the equation is where people like me come in. Our job is to give these young Australians the chance to perform in Australia for their home audiences. And I think it behoves any company now, if they've got a chance or a choice to showcase Australians, they must do it. We're very, very lucky to have people like most providing the funding for young kids to go overseas and study. It's up to us now to bring those young kids back to showcase what they can do for their home audiences. For me, I'm completely honoured to be given this award, and I look forward to many, many opportunities to showcase many, many more winners and finalists in the Marty Awards. Thank you very much for the honour.
Thank you, Roland and Anne-Marie, and congratulations to Stuart. Well, it's the moment we've all been waiting for, not least the nervous young singers backstage. Let's put them out of their misery as we invite National Adjudicator Patrick Torr to the stage. Please welcome Patrick Torr.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Earlier tonight, I asked the organisers for a running order of this evening's events, and I saw that they allocated 8 minutes to the speech for the National Adjudicator. Unless anyone objects, I'm happy to reduce that to 90 seconds. I'd just like to say two things, if I may. Firstly, thank you to most for dedicating this evening to my late wife, Romola Tyrrell. The past 2 months have been very difficult for me and my children, Michaela and Matthew. Thanks to all in the classical music community for your support. But particularly thank you, Roland, Amelia, David and Maria, for accommodating me as the National Adjudicator during this period. I'd like also to thank my fellow adjudicators this evening, Nicole, Dorigo, Amelia, Farrugia, Paul Fitzsimon, and Dr. Anke, Höeppner-Ryan. There's just one more thing I'd like to say before we announce all the awards. We're here in a beautiful hall. Dish Tora Hala. For the past 50 to 60 years, those of us who care about culture, particularly music, in this part of the world, have built many halls like this one. Just down the road, we've built the world's most famous opera house, many other wonderful temples of high art around Australia and New Zealand. The five singers you heard this evening are not entertainers. They're artists. They engage in the practice of high art. We love them, we support them. We hold competitions like this so that they can receive funds to finish their training. But I'd like us to remember one thing. We need to be ready to welcome them home. Us older folks need to set things up so that there are performance opportunities for these artists well into the future. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Patrick. And before the presentation of the incredible list of prizes and opportunities, let's call all the finalists on stage for the announcement of individual awards. Michaela Cadwgan. Cassandra Doyle. Ellena Hicks. Emmanuel Fonoti-Fuimaono. And Yvette Keong. Congratulations to you all on your wonderful performances this evening. Now, Patrick, if you're ready. We are about to announce the prizes. Sponsored by Opera Australia, in recognition of reaching this stage of the competition, the five finalists are each awarded the Opera Australia Prize, which is an opportunity to attend rehearsals in Melbourne or Sydney, observing an opera throughout the stages of its production. The Canadian International Vocal Arts Institute Scholarship, an opportunity to attend the Institute's summer program in Montreal. The winner also receives the Nel Pascal Award to assist with travel expenses, and the scholarship is awarded too.
Well, this is a terrific prize because the newly appointed artistic directors are Nicole Carr and her husband, Etienne Dupuis. The scholarship is awarded to Cassandra Doyle.
The Zeke Solomon Award, a scholarship of up to $5,000 Australian to fund travel and accommodation to attend the Israeli Opera Young Artist Program at the Meitar Opera Studio in Tel Aviv. This prize is generously sponsored by Zeke Solomon and has been awarded to...
I haven't seen Zeke for years. How are you, Zeke? I'll look forward to catching up with you afterwards. What a tremendous patron of the arts Zeke has been to so many artists. This prize is awarded to Cassandra Doyle.
The Nicole Carr Prize, a cash prize valued at $6,250 to cover the cost of accommodation and flights to and from Paris. It provides the opportunity to meet with and receive mentoring from international soprano Nicole Carr. And this wonderful prize has been won by...
The Nicole Carr Prize goes to Cassandra Doyle.
The Saluzzo Opera Academy Scholarship, a scholarship to attend the 2024 Saluzzo Opera Academy, including tuition and accommodation in Saluzzo, Italy. The winner will also receive the $7,000 Merenda Travel Prize. And this scholarship is awarded to... That one,
yeah. Okay. The Saluzzo Opera Academy Scholarship is awarded to Michaela Cadwgan.
The Merenda Legacy Prize, a grant of up to $7,000 to study the Italian language in Italy, is awarded to...
The Merenda Legacy Prize, $7,000, is awarded to Yvette Keong.
The Royal Northern College of Music Award is a scholarship for 1 year study at the Royal Northern College of Music in Manchester. The winner will also receive the Pasqualina Lipari Prize, sponsored by V&A Accountants to assist with travel expenses. And the award goes to?
This is such a generous award, and I know so many famous Australian singers who've attended the Royal Northern College. The award goes to Ellena Hicks.
And now it's time to hear who you, the audience, have chosen as your winner. The most audience prize is a cash prize of $500, with the recipient determined by audience vote. And you have selected...
So the most audience prize goes to Michaela Cadwgan.
And the member of the audience who has won the Nespresso prize pack is Olena Rosenfeld. Our office will be in touch to arrange collection of your prize next week. And finally, just before this year's Marty winner is announced, could I extend a big congratulations and thank you to Roland Gridiger, Chief Executive Officer, together with the MOST team for another wonderful year. Well, in addition to the Marianne Marty Scholarship of $30,000 to assist with vocal study or career advancement, the winner will receive the audition prize from Lyric Opera of Chicago's Ryan Opera Center, an opportunity to audition for Lyric Opera of Chicago's Professional Artist Development Program, the Patrick G. and Shirley W. Ryan Opera Center in Chicago. The Lily Usher Portrait Prize, a portrait painting of the winner in concert dress. The Oral History Award, a taped interview by oral historian Diana Rich, will be recorded and retained within the oral history collection of the National Library of Australia. And they will also receive this beautiful limited edition statuette by Drago Marin Cerina. And now to announce the winner.
It is with great pleasure that I announce that the 2023 Marianne Marty Scholarship has been won by Emmanuel Fonoti-Fuimaono.
Congratulations, Emmanuel. And now it's your turn at the microphone. Ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to introduce, speaking for the first time as the 2023 Marty Award winner, Emmanuel Fonoti-Fuimaono.
Oh my God, oh wow, hi. I didn't usually use these. So I was told to say a few things. Wow. Sorry, I also got 2 minutes, right? That's the limit. I've already wasted 30 seconds. First of all, thank God. Thank you for bringing me here. I get to meet you all from me being able to take on this career. Oh, well, I've got one Kiwi here, and it's Andrew, and I just had to make note that, like, there was one Kiwi there, but everyone at home, my mum, my siblings, all my family, my teachers, Nikki Lee Hartleap and David Harper, supporters, Sir William and Lady Judy Gallagher, David Mace, Paul and Carol Stigley, Joanne LeGru, to my fellow competitors, holy, I bet the adjudicators had a hard time. To the adjudicators, to Camille for running our concert, to Maestro Vladimir and the Opera Australia Orchestra, this has been an opportunity of a lifetime. To Dr. Handa for making this all happen. It's not often where young singers get to perform with such a highly respected orchestra, and I'll hold that with me forever, so that's amazing. To the Dame Malvina Major Foundation, to Pai Kōkako, the Aotearoa New Zealand Opera Studio, Project Prima Volta, the Dame Kiri Te Kanawa Foundation, my Ewhakasa Hastings Church, to most, for organising this whole thing, to Amelia, David, Maria, and the whole crew. I hope to be a role model to allow all singers to keep going. And that if I can do it, you can do it. It sounds cheesy, but it's true. Just, you know, keep your close ones closer, I guess, hug them tighter. Have manners, and he'll be sweet. So, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of the IFAC Handa Australian Singing Competition Finals Concert. We bid farewell with our thanks to Patrick Torr and this evening's magnificent performers. Our thanks again to the five finalists, our guest artists Ellena Greenwood, Vladimir Fanshil and the Opera Australia Orchestra, the adjudicators and organisers for all their hard work, and ladies and gentlemen of the audience, I thank you for your enthusiastic appreciation of these remarkable singers and your continuing support of the Australian Singing Competition. Thank you to the directors and staff at the Concourse, and we look forward to your attendance at next year's finals concert, noted in your diary, on Thursday, the 19th of September, 2024. Good evening to you all, and thank you.